Hello everyone. Today we are going to solve the cloud assignment number 2, that is based on the network storage virtualization. In this video, we are going to solve the question number 1, that is based on the network virtualization. In the first question, there are 3 parts A, B, C, and let me start with the first part, that is A. In question number 1 and the A part, we have to create 2 switch, SW1, SW2, and there should be 2 VLAN, VLAN 10, VLAN 20, and each switch will be connected to you can say 4 IP addresses, and each VLAN net is connected to 4 port. That is, VLAN 10 is connected to 11, 12, 13, 14, and VLAN 20 is connected to 4. So let me show this representation in the Cisco tracer. Here we have this switch 0, and you can say switch 1, here are 3 switches, and since we have to connect it 4 port, so I will take one more PC also. I can place it here. I can use the Ethernet connection also. So basically, this is the I'm explaining all this layout in a single connection, so that all fitted in every PC connections. And here I'm writing the IP. The time means which this PC will belong to the VLAN 10, and the port number is 12. The port gateway is same for everyone, so I will take it as it is. And this default gateway will be same for the VLAN 10, and if I have to create for VLAN 20, I will just replace 10 with 20. So for VLAN 20, I will replace this. And so finally, I have created the kind of UI or the kind of command I have used to create this PC. All the activities were also done in the same way. So let me start with the final solution for the question we're asked in the assignment. That is part 1. Send broadcast message from host 1 LAN 10 to all other VLAN 10 port directly. Okay. So we are asking in this question is that we have to send the data from the VLAN 10 from 11 port to all other VLAN 10, that is 12, 13, 14. So what we will do is we will go to the command prompt and write the command here. Okay. First we will send our packet from 11 to 12. We are getting the ping, that is, we are getting that data is getting transferred to the port 12. Now we'll try for port 13. Same, we are getting port 13 also. Let's try for port 14. Finally, we were able to transfer all the packet from the PC11 to all other PCs on the same VLAN, that is VLAN 10. So we can say that the party is successful. Now we'll go for the second part. Can you send data from the VLAN 10 to VLAN 20? If yes, which network device can be used to connect these virtual LAN implement network sharing using packet tracer? The first thing is, can we transfer the data from VLAN 10 to VLAN 20, either 21, 22, 23, 24? Yes, we can transfer the data. And which network device can be used? We can use the routers. If we have to connect different LAN, then we can use the router connections. And now we'll implement this scenario in the packet tracer. So let's go with again the layout. So we have used the router here to connect this VLAN 10 to VLAN 20. And we have to transfer the packet from the end of the PC of the VLAN 10 to VLAN 20 to any other PC. And we will verify this with the help of command. So let me start with the 30. And we'll transfer the data from the same VLAN, whether it's VLAN 10 or to the VLAN 20 or the different pieces. So that we can verify that we are able to transfer the data between different local area networks. So we can go to command prompt. I'll write the ping. 192.168. This command means that we are sending data from the PC 13 to virtual network that is 20 and to the port of 21, that is PC 21. Let's see whether we are able to get the thing or not. Yes, we are getting it. So it's quite sure that we are getting the data transaction between the two virtual LAN network with the help of router. And let me try with few more examples also. I will pass to the 24 port also. Yes, I'm getting the same. Let again change the same network. I need to 11. Yes, I am getting the same. Let me try for the also. So we are able to transfer the data. We are able to transfer the data between VLAN 10 to VLAN 20 with the different PCs. And this was the part B of the question. And the simulation also verified in the command prompt window. So I guess this is the final solution of the part A solution. And if you guys have any query or doubt, you can ask